What's going on, everybody? Josh Engelman for AwesomeO.com, and I am back with my NBA DFS contenders on FanDuel for Friday, February 26th. Now be sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you know when this and all of our other content goes live. Follow me on Twitter, at Josh Engelman, so you can get updates to my sim results as we get closer to lock. And finally, let me know in the comments section who are your favorite options for tonight's slate. We're rounding out the bottom of my top 10 with OG Anunoby, Sadiq Bey, Kemba Walker, Josh Jackson, and Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. There's no value on this slate once again. It's really crazy. Who will be my favorites, my top five plays for today? It's time to find out. First up, number five, I'm going to Jeremy Grant. Power forward eligibility, 7,600. Projected for 40. The goal's 48. He's in the optimal lineup 26% of the time. Grant sat out the last game for rest. Now I think he's right back to it. 35 minutes, 1.15 fantasy points per minute, 28% usage, 24 points or thereabouts, 5 rebounds, couple assists. Here's the big piece though. Taking on the Sacramento Kings, this is a slight pace-up matchup against Sacramento, and they're one of the worst defenses in basketball. They've been giving up a ton of points. I think that fits perfectly for Grant. Hoping he got a little bit more energy back in the batteries with the day off. He has been carrying a pretty big load, but I know I play Jeremy Grant a lot. This is a fantastic spot as a game as well. Being able to attack the Kings, as you can see, I've got Josh Jackson on here. I've got Sadiq Bey on here. This is a really nice spot for the Pistons to put up some fantasy points, and I am starting at the top with Jeremy Grant. Next up, number four, I'm going Enes Kanter. Center eligibility, 6,300, projected for 36. The goal's 44. He's in the optimal lineup 27% of the time. I think he plays solid minutes, 31. I'm not worried about a center matchup, whether it's Marcus Gasol or whether it's Montrezl Harrell. That should be fine. 1.17 fantasy points per minute, projected for 13.2 points, 13.7 rebounds. Crazy stat line, projected for more rebounds than points. You don't see that all that frequently. Pace neutral spot against the Lakers. They're normally a really good defense. I think that's a very different scenario when Anthony Davis isn't healthy. And I just think the upside of Kanter and his ability to hang a very large double-double is really difficult to skip over for 6,300. It's a day where we don't have a ton of value, so Kanter's making the mid-tier look a little bit better. Next up at number three, we're going De'Aaron Fox. Point guard eligibility, 7,800, projected for 43. The goal is 49. He's in the optimal lineup 27% of the time. We kind of know what we're getting out of Fox. 1.17 fantasy points per minute normally. I think it's a little bit higher for this matchup, so we'll just call it 1.2 for right now. 31% usage, 24 points, almost 8 assists, 4 boards, 2 stocks, and as good of a matchup as you're going to find against the Pistons. There's not a lot of legitimate NBA talent on this roster. A lot of also type guys, you know what I mean. It's not the spot. So Fox, with the way that he likes to push the ball, should be able to run it straight down the Pistons' throat. It's not like Plumlee is going to be chasing him back with any sort of zest or esteem. I don't know what words I'm using anymore. Guys, it's Friday. It has been such a long week. The things that come up in my mind right now are clearly not the words that I'm looking for, but I'm spitting them right back out in your faces. So either way, the data is the data, and that's really all that matters. De'Aaron Fox looks great. He should be priced a little bit higher for this spot, for the minutes that he plays, and for the role that he has in this offense. I have no issue whatsoever having De'Aaron Fox be one of my favorite plays of the day. I expect him to be incredibly chalky. He has been very popular as of late. The price tag is just lower than it should be. Get some Fox. Next up, number two, Isaiah Roby, one of the few places we can find value today. Power forward eligibility, 4,600, projected for 27, goal is 38, optimal lineup, 30% of the time. No Al Horford, out for rest today. We're not going to have Hamadou Diallo either. I don't think that really matters much for Roby, but it's just another body out. I'm giving him 27 minutes, assuming he starts. If not, we might have to move this around. Muscala would come up a little bit, but Roby's a 1 fantasy point per minute guy in what should be a starting role for Oklahoma City against the Atlanta Hawks today. 18% usage, 12 points, 6.5 boards, 2 stocks. It's a pretty pedestrian line, and I think that we could see Roby fall in this list if we open up any value, but oddly enough, we're looking kind of like yesterday with very minimal value to be found outside of what was that Knicks situation. Only this time we're on a 9-game slate. That makes it a little bit difficult. So I've got my eye on Isaiah Roby. I assume he falls down the list a little bit as we go through the day, but either way, with Horford out, Roby is a value play that you have to keep in your player pool. Now, before we get to my number one play, one last reminder, hit that thumbs up, helps me out a ton. Subscribe to the channel. That one's another biggie too. Just because we hit 50,000 subscribers doesn't mean we're trying to stop. And let me know in the comments section, who's your favorite contender of mine and your least favorite contender of the 10 guys that I'm listing here? By the way, you gotta follow this guy on Twitter, at Josh Engelman, for two reasons. One, I do post my updates there. You don't want to miss them. And two, Lofty thinks he's going to have significantly more followers than me at the end of this year, and I'm going to catch him unless he keeps giving away top shots. And finally, the number one contender for today. I couldn't be happier. It's LaMelo Ball. Point guard eligibility, just 7,600. I have him projected for 43 fantasy points. The goal is 48.5. I think he's in the optimal lineup 32% of the time. What's not to like here? 35 minutes, 1.22 fantasy points per minute, 24% usage, close to 19 points, 7 boards, 7 assists, 2 steals, a massive pace up spot against the Warriors where they gain 3 possessions over their average, and quite possibly we see LaMelo Ball with a little bit of a chip on his shoulder thinking, hey, Golden State, maybe you should have drafted me. I don't know. Maybe that's a thought process that goes through his head. That doesn't matter to me at all. He's the number one play on this slate for no narrative whatsoever, other than the fact that 7,600 for the role that he has in this offense is way too cheap. LaMelo Ball is the number one contender, and I'm excited to roster him tonight. Alrighty, folks, that will do it. Those are my NBA DFS contenders on FanDuel for Friday, February 26th. That's it for the week. We're done. We're taking Saturday and Sunday off. No more contenders videos. I'll be back again Monday morning with another edition of the contenders. Good luck tonight, everybody, and have a good weekend.